הסופר יעקב שבתאי נפטר באופן פתאומי מהתקף לב בביתו בתל אביב. השאיר אישה ושתי בנות סטודנטיות. אני הייתי אז תינוקת בת 8 חודשים, אך דבר קיומי לא צוין בידיעה. ייתכן שמי שכתב אותה לא ידע עוד את הולדתי. ייתכן ששמע שמועות, אך לא היה בטוח בנכונותן. וייתכן גם שידע הכל, אך החליט למרות זאת לא לכתוב שהסופר המנוח השאיר אחריו בת נוספת, שנולדה לו מאהובתו, אימה ניהל רומן בן עשור, בעודו נשוי.
And joining us now is the baby that you just saw that is all grown up and the director of this fine movie about her late father, the famous author Yaakov Shabtai. And please welcome Noah to the show.
Hi,
welcome.
Hi.
Nice, and congratulations.
Thank you so much.
So I know that this is something that you worked on, you know, for a long time. I imagine, like, the process was really, because it's very, very personal, it's about your life of losing your father and, you know, it was through an affair with your mother. I mean, at what age did you actually, you know, did your mom start talking to you about this?
Well, actually, I don't remember an age where she sat me down and said, here's the story. I mean, I think it was, like, all over, I mean, during my childhood, it was in something in the air, and I knew that. I knew it was, the word affair was not foreign to me. I knew it. But just, I mean, especially because of that, because of it, there was no moment like this, I think I kind of knew but didn't know. It's difficult to explain.
Well, because I imagine, I mean, how did your mom explain when you would ask, like, you know, who's my father? I mean, that's, like, very, you know, typical questions to ask. So when you, you know, kind of found out the story, I mean, what was that like for you in your own journey of, I mean, obviously it's got to be, I imagine, hardest on your mom and you, and then not ever having a chance to meet him.
I know, yeah. I think that I felt during my childhood and then also when I grew up, it's like a void that keeps, you know, getting bigger and bigger. And you feel a sense of emptiness that you need to feel. And I felt the need ever since I think I was 20. It became really, really urgent for me to get to know my father and to get to know the story behind their relationship. And so that's when I think I first started to think about making a film about him. Mm-hmm. And then it took me a few years to gain, you know, the power.
Of course, I mean, because it's like you feel this pull of something, a story you have to tell, but it is so, you know, emotional and deep. So you basically started going through, you know, like archival stuff that you had access to.
Yeah.
And what was the, you know, like, I mean, were a lot of what you found like just really shocking, or was it just more of like building the story of kind of getting to know what his personality was?
Well, I think one of the main questions that I thought out to figure out was, I think it's a question that every child needs to know, that he was wanted, you know. Mm. It's a really, really, really intense question to investigate in my, you know, my...
Of course.
But it was really important for me to see. So I kind of asked my mother about that, and I opened letters that he wrote to her about that, and I talked to friends of him. And what I realized at the end, it was very, very complex, that it's not black and white. I think, you know, it was, you know, he really grappled with it, but eventually I think he did love me, which was something for me very, very important to know.
Of course, and you know, finally kind of get that closure. So let's talk about also showing your film at this huge literary, you know, event in Istanbul last week. And I mean, so how many different, I know they brought in so many different writers, so how many people were there from, you know, how many countries? And that you,
well, it was, I think, about 50 or 60 people, but this was just like the people that came from abroad. There were many Turkish writers and Turkish publishers. It was really a big festival and a festivity of just celebrating literature. And it was really, really nice, especially, you know, after what we see happening this week.
Exactly. So, I mean, like, Turkey is literally, with all the tension, they've expelled the, you know, the consul. I mean, it's really, you know, not a safe place to be. And we know that, like, you know, the relationship between Turkey and Israel has kind of gone up and down over the years. So how did you feel when you were there last week? Did you feel the tension knowing, you know, the embassy move and all of these, you know, big events were happening in the Middle East?
No, I think that's the interesting idea. Thing is that I was there, when I was there, everything seems normal, you know? I mean, I was in Taksim Square, everything seemed calm and normal. And the people that I was in touch with and that I talked to were people, liberal people, you know, from the arts.
Right, other artists, other literary figures, right?
Yes. So when I talked to them, there was no politics and, you know, nothing in between. It was just, you know, literature and art. And I know it's a cliche, but it's true in this sense. So it's so weird to be here now and to see, you know, what's happening. It's really like it's not the same country that I've been visiting.
Yeah, I bet. I mean, all of this happened like what, within days after you left?
Yeah, so. Fallout. Yeah.
Wow. Well, it's really fantastic though that you got a chance to go and meet other people, and you realize that, you know, literature, art kind of transcends politics. And at the end of the day, it was great to kind of be in such a, you know, a cultural eclectic group of people. So great to meet you.
Thank you
and
so much.
Continued great work.
Thank you.